by integrating your UniFi camera systems into Hummer system, you're gonna get a lot more information and control with them. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to set it up step by step, and I'm also gonna leave you with some awesome ideas for automations that you can implement with these cameras. But first, let's roll the intro. I'm using a UniFi Dream Machine SE, but this is also compatible if you have got the NVR. So let's jump into the console and let's go to the users. So click on users, you'll find it here on the left-hand side. And we're going to click on add users, which you can see over here. For this user, we want to add it as an administrator. We're going to change the account time to local access only. The username, give it a username that you sort of remember. Now it's time to create a really super secure password. What we're actually doing is creating a user that can actually access your cameras. So super, super important. Go to a random generator site, generate a password, and then store it in your keychain of choice. You can leave employee ID and onboard date blank. I'm going to give it a quick name. And now you can click the add button. An important step before we jump into Hummer system is the add the RTSP streams. You're going to need to do this for each camera, so I'm just going to show you only one. Go to your UniFi Protect and pick one of your cameras. Go into settings, scroll down, go to advanced, and you can see the real-time streaming protocol. You can enable high, medium, or low depending on what type of camera you have. I always recommend enabling the highest stream. And then you will have the actual IP address, the actual link, and you can actually use this in different applications, not just in Home Assistant. So go ahead and do that for all of your devices. Now, some cameras have a different resolution. For example, the G3 Instant has only 1080p resolution, whereas the G4 Bullet had the 2K resolution, as you can see over here. Now it's time to jump into Home Assistant. We're going to need to go to the Integrations tab. Now go to configurations, click devices and services, and you'll find integrations under there. Now this will depend on what type of version you're using in Home Assistant. So the menus have changed quite a lot, but this is actually where it is currently in the version that I'm running. So you can see you have the UDMESE UniFi Protect discovered. So just click on configure. Now we need to put our username and password. This is the local user that we created at the beginning of the video. Cool, successful, absolutely straightforward to do. And we have all of the devices popping up, and now pick a appropriate area where you actually want to put them. So if you've named your cameras appropriately, this should be very easy to do. Click finish. And now if we scroll a little bit down, we should have our 6 devices and 144 entities, which is gigantic. Let's start with the UDM Pro SE, which is the actual recording device. So by clicking on a device, we can see some of the metrics that we have. So we have diagnostic metrics for this device specifically. So we've got things like free space. We've got like storage utilization, continuous video, detection video, time lapse, uptime. So we see more details over here. If you wanted to add any of these to a dashboard, you can just do that by clicking add to dashboard, simply. Let's go back and let's have a look at one of the cameras. So depending on which camera you have, your different features. Let's check a G3 Flex. Here we have the actual recording. So this is the actual camera sensor. We have the is dark on and on, off and on. So it's basically telling me the room is dark. We have motion, clear. We have some set configuration settings of HDR, infrared, microphone level. We've got settings with the overlay. So these things that you can control in UniFi Protect. The recording mode, which is always never in detection. So at this point, I want to stop 1 second just to point out a very cool automation that you can make. So you can change the recording mode. So let's say if you're at home, you put it as never. When you're outside, you put it always. If you found that tip cool, remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel. If you're actually interested in me making these automations for you in Home Assistant or Node-RED, comment in the section down below and let me know. Stage light is going to tell you if it's on and off with that LED. Privacy mode is also an interesting one, which I need to look into. So a lot of features coming from a G3 Flex. Now I would imagine the G3 dome will have the same set of configuration. I'm just gonna jump in and check the G3 instant. And this is the actual camera that is recording now behind me. The motion is clear, it says at the moment. We have similar settings. I think we've also got something like system sounds, which I didn't quite see before, which is quite interesting. Now let's check the G4 bullet. So the G4 bullet has extra capabilities because G4s don't actually have object detection. So we see detected object. Now I would like to test this out a little bit and understand what type of objects it can detect. But we've got the camera stream over here, it is dark, and the motion. And we've got configurations around people and vehicle HDR. So this is quite, these two configurations are unique to the G4. And scrolling down, you can see a bit more information about storage and disk space. So I'm in an empty dashboard in Home Assistant. I'm going to edit the dashboard and add a card. I'm going to be using a picture entity. I'm going to click on it. And now I'm going to pick the camera entity. So I'm going to try and pick, let's go with the garden one. So we can feel free to clear this image path out. We've got options here to show the name and show the state. We can do different things with the tap actions. So here's the current stream. You can find it over here. You can set this to auto live. So if you have it live, it means that it will be constantly streaming on a dashboard. Now at the top, we need to change the entity also to the camera. Let's set it up as a garden. And you can see the state recording. So we save it and put it as done. We can see that we have the recording of the actual device coming in through. And if we actually click on it, we get this live stream with some sort of a delay actually going on. I'm gonna leave you now with a video that I made some time ago with different cameras, but it will absolutely work with any type of camera you integrate into Home Assistant. And it's a video where I'm gonna show you how you can set up a doorbell notification, I send you an image, and then you actually open a garage door. And actually, interesting thing that you can set these notifications with camera snippets and even recordings being sent to your phone, where you can then do things called actionable notifications in Home Assistant, which allows you to trigger some command like sounding an alarm, opening a door. So it really opens up a lot of things. You do click the video over here and you enjoy it. I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.